What's up, YouTube? I am here today to do pad replacement, which is it's really boring. So we're not going to really show the pad replacement. We're going to show the stretching back into place with the new Triforce stretching attachment. We're going to do that. I did it for the first time yesterday, so I do plan on switching to the new tool, and I'm going to go through the trouble of learning to use it rather than and stuck in the same mindset of always doing everything the same way. All right, so first thing I'm gonna do, so I'm gonna turn the camera around and show you where I'm starting, and then we'll just kinda go through the job and then get to the stretching part, which is almost fun to watch. Hang on. All right, there is this big master bedroom here. Show the rest of this. All this guy here, I'm gonna put pad in it. And this closet right here, we're gonna do this guy too. And then there are two half rooms, but we're gonna do the whole room. She got enough pad to do the whole room, so we're gonna do that. Pad replacements. I don't know, it's not terribly laborious, but it's not a lot of fun either, so. Anyway, I'm just happy I get to use a new tool. That's what breathes new life into an old task. Somehow, like for some reason, YouTube has breathed new life into an old task of carpet. I've seen so much carpet, I don't even know what to do, but some people out there find it interesting, so that's all I got to do, so I'm gonna share it on YouTube daily. All right, I'm gonna bring my carpet over here and roll it out and maybe show a little bit of that. Check in a minute. All right, I want to get a little catch up here. You see you've got the pad under here and not there. And what I did over here, I made a cut at the door because it makes a little more work putting it back together, but rolling this entire closet out, fitting it through this door, dragging it all the way across this room and fighting with it just seems like it would be more effort than simply splicing that back together over there. Anyway, the next order of business here is to roll this guy back and roll this out. And this is gonna miss probably a chunk in the center, probably about at least that big, I'm thinking. So I have to run a strip up the middle because that got you 6 feet there. 6 feet over is gonna wind you up about right here probably. So I'm gonna miss that. And then beyond that, I'm gonna pull everything out of here and put the pad under the carpet. And this is the offending hot water heater that looks like it blew a turd out of it. I don't know, that's pretty ugly. But anyway, it's still sitting here and I got a new one out there. This house is put together completely different than a lot of houses. It's weird because, let me just show you just because it's got the potty and a little vanity thing here, which I've never seen before. All the baseboards are off. And the kitchen's got a different kind of setup too. And look at that. It's got the stove. Seems like located real peculiar, like. See, that's different. I've never seen a kitchen laid out quite like this before. Anyway, the house was probably built in the 70s and then and redone. It's definitely been built in at least the 70s or maybe the early 80s, and probably Chip and Joanne at least one time. And then now is there's carpet under this room here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the other two rooms first because I've got two complete rolls, and I don't want to cut into those rolls to get cuts like this out of them. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna replace the pad under both of those first, and then I'll do the front of each of these, and I will do these closets and those closets kind of all at the same time here. And when I'm done, the leftover pieces is what I'm gonna use to put in the closet. To me, that seems more reasonable. Show you what I've got in stash over here. They've got started out with three, I've got two big rolls left. I've been sending everybody to my, I got this one carpet supplier, and I'm getting to the point now where I don't know if they appreciate me sending all this business to them or if they're upset, because generally when I send somebody to them, I'm not going to be able to sell them the carpet. I'm fixing the carpet, so, you know, in theory, every carpet that I fix, they don't get to replace. So I don't know if I need to call down there and ask them, hey, man, how do you feel about me sending all those people down there? Is that something you enjoy? You want me to quit or what? So I was in there last week picking up some carpet myself or some pad for a client. And they asked me, a lady asked me in there, she goes, are you the guy that sent that person down here that wanted 2 foot by 2 foot of carpet? How the hell do I know what somebody says when they go down there? How about thanks for all the business? Because I have sent them a handful of commercial installs and whole house installs that they wouldn't have gotten otherwise. But a lot of times people forget about that and they want to focus on the fact that somebody walked in and asked them for 2 foot by 2 foot of carpet. Well, I've got my minimums as well, so I need to learn how to take care of their minimums and appreciate the business that I've been trying to send. Generally, when people send me business, I'll send them a text and go, thank you for sending the business. That way they feel appreciated and they'll do more of it. All right, I'm gonna roll this carpet back. All right, this is just an update here where we're at. This is what's been done since we spoke last. It's updated. I'm gonna fill in the gaps here. Got a little to do there. A little to do here. Got that to fill in. I'm gonna save all the carpet stretching until last. This guy is done here. Gotta fill in this part here and the closet. And then over here, there is this super secret closet that I didn't notice when I first got here. It's a, if you're a moth, you wouldn't be in there. Cedar closet. And the big master closet with the water heater in it, ready to get your shoes wet. All that. All right, and then at the very, very, very end, I'm gonna set up the camera on a little tripod, and I'm gonna let you watch me learn like an idiot how to use this, because I've never used a conventional stretcher, always the mini stretchers. So this is a completely different concept for me. Yesterday I had a buddy of mine, Ruben, over at Floors by Southern Boys. I was talking in the video, I go, I don't really know exactly how far away from the wall to place this. And the other thing I don't really know is just how much of a bite you need to put in the carpet. You know, so there's a lot of fine tuning I need to do to get good with this. And really, there's nobody that can actually tell you. You've got to find that on your own, where your own happy place is. But basically, yesterday I was stretching out from about here. And he goes, no, that's not how you do that. He says you need to be about a hand's width away from the wall to tuck it in a pin. So we're going to do that today. And I'm planning on switching to this guy full time. It's just going to, you're going to get to watch me learn. So I guess I'm going to have some fun made of me on this channel here for a little bit. Anyway, as long as it's all in good humor, I don't mind. Okay, check it out. Check back in here in a minute. All right, guys. All kind of stuff's happened since we spoke last here. Start over here, I guess. I reattached the closets here. So now is the part where I guess this is definitely a friendlier job to do than the one I did yesterday with the new tool. Anyway, I'm starting over here in this room. I'm going to finish up in the one that I feel like is the most difficult. Let me set this tool bag down here. All right, show you what's going on here. What I got right now is I have attached the closet, put the closet in here, and then I've attached the carpet all along here and here. So we're gonna stretch it this way a little bit. And I've got the tiny tripod, so I think it'll work. If not, I'll go get a taller one maybe if I need to. Let's see what it looks like I can see here. All right, well, we will shoot it from several different angles, I guess. Here. Something like that. I'm gonna bring my stair tool. Dummy, dummy, dummy. All right. It'll take a little bit to get used to this guy. It is definitely different. Exactly sure if I'm doing it right. I'm too stubborn to ask. So eventually I'm gonna have to get a hold of the guy that they created it to figure out exactly how to do this best. Alright, keep trying. Part of the learning curve here. I don't think there's a lot of guys that would let you watch them make mistakes and try to figure this out on their YouTube channel, I'm pretty sure. So let's get a little closer. This time I left my mini stretchers in the van.
Man, that's difficult when you don't know what you're doing.
All right, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut the camera off. I'll make a phone call here to the guy that put it together and see if he can give me some tips on how to do this and maybe save the learning curve a little bit. All right, all done with this room now. I had a talk with the guy that created the tool. He is, I believe he said he's 80, which is just fascinating that someone that's been in the business so long is still trying to make it better. Anyway, what he said was basically you start in the middle of the room and work your way out. And a lot of this, you got to forgive me because I've always only ever stretched with mini stretchers. So the entire way that I've done it has now changed for me. So I'm just trying to get my feelings here on how to do this. So I'm basically pushing carpet rather than pulling it when I stretch. So this one didn't need much. So I started in the middle and I worked my way to the left, worked my way to the right. And you'll notice that when you push on the tool, that you'll get a couple bumps here in the back. He said that they've done tests where they left it on the carpet for 72 hours. And when you take it off, they still go away because of the elasticity of the carpet. So you can stretch as much as 20 feet back in some situations and just have those two little divots in the carpet on the outside that will go away because it pulls the carpet from between those two feet. Anyway, it's gonna take a little getting used to. So right now I'm not the best spokesman for the tool, but I'm working on it. I like it. I like it better. I know that in the future I'll like it a whole lot better. I've just gotta take some time now to get used to it. So I'm gonna get started in this room and try to cover some of it as I'm gonna learn. You got what you're in hand, it'll get you. All right, I've got it narrowed down to that wall there. And it is just a needs a little bit stretching to get it to touch. So anyway, let me show you everything else. It's all in, everything's working good. It's just I'm investing the time today to learn to use a new tool. And it is, you know, cutting into productivity because it takes a little bit to learn something new, but I feel like it's worth the time invested in the end because I really like the way it's working. Anyway, all done here. All this is left. So I'm gonna try to set this up in a manner that you can see something, anything. Nothing to set it up on, I don't believe. I'm gonna see if I can find something to set it up on the camera here. All right, got you sitting up here on my cooler. So let's see if maybe this will. I don't know. All right, here we go. See where that handle could cause a world of hurt if it was to get you just right.
if that's a legal move or not. Throwing one leg over the machine, who knows? Check the carpet rule book. Here, not much. All right. Doesn't need much right there. Now, put all this in there. Now we're gonna take this guy in. And that will be it. But, not done yet. Basically, if you have always stretched with a conventional stretcher, you would probably absolutely love this tool. Me, I like it. However, as I've said before, I've never used a conventional stretcher. It's always a mini stretcher, so it's all new to me.
All right. Now, tune in 3 weeks when I know how to use this tool better. We're all done here. So, all right, I'm done. I officially got my ass kicked by that tool. No doubt about that. No doubt at all. Anyway, you know when you score real big and you know when you got a lot to learn, and that is what's going on right now with this tool. Got a lot to learn, but I look forward to learning because I feel like it's going to be a great benefit to me here in the near future. All right, I'm going to pack up now. It's kind of a little late. So I'm actually going to drive an hour to do a carpet repair outside of town here. So I'm going to load up, and I will see y'all shortly. Thanks for watching, and God bless.